pretty much playing this as a new player. I don't know how they changed the story with 5.3, 5.4. They streamlined it, so we'll find that out together, I guess. Each of these is going to be around an hour, and will be released on a Friday. Other than that, sit back and enjoy, I guess. We'll also turn on text auto advance because that makes life so much easier. Keep it pretty high so that the speed advances and we'll keep this all rolling in the right direction. For me, it's none of those, so... I'm gonna skip through that bit, because as I said, I've already played, so I can always open New Game Plus later and see if we can go through. But for now, we're gonna aim to make progress.
On a windswept isle, in the southwestern corner of the realm. Amidst the roiling waves of the Lotana, lies the maritime city-state of Limsa Lominsa. To this haven for bandits and brigands, cutthroats and curs, seekers of both freedom and fortune, comes a lone adventurer. Lone yet not alone, for the hero's arrival has drawn the gaze of the nation's patron deity, Lim Lane. What realm-shaking fate has she descried in the churning waters of this mortal's future? Through peril and hardship, discovery and triumph, may the navigator guide this brave soul on his life's voyage. Till sea swallows all.
Okay, so now our adventure begins. And of course, 30 seconds off the boat and I'm in trouble, which sounds about right. I'm going to use controller because that's how I have it set up. I'll skip through them, but if you want to read them, then you can pause the video at each point. So we'll obviously turn this one in. I'm just going to get past this bit and then we can start some actual gameplay. So we have disappearing people, an intriguing mystery indeed. I'm sure that somewhere down the line we'll get to solve that. So the plan for this is to go through and grab content, game content, story, that kind of thing. Anything with a blue marker will be done along the way as we go. So anything like that, we'll be doing as we go. I picked Arcanist because it's the class that I know best. It's the one that I've played most, being a Scholar main myself, but I also play Summoner quite a bit now, mostly because I'm lazy. So that's why I picked Arcanist. Also, I haven't really seen the Limsa story much. So that's another reason. Obviously, I'll focus on one class and getting through the main story with a little luck I made. Get this done before the next piece comes out. I'm gonna grab that because it's kind of integral. And then I'm gonna run up here. Oh, okay. I can't go that way. That's interesting. So I will grab all the etherites as well on my way through here. I know on one of the earlier ones I forgot to do that, I'm sorry. If you want to see what it says, just drop me a message and I'll be sure to pop it up. I think I can still access it from the help system, so. Also, while I'm playing this and getting through, I might run other bits on Twitch, maybe alternate classes and things. The main story will always be done through this system, so that it all gets sent to YouTube and you can watch it. Then at some point, I will slice up the bottle back. I will slice up the boss battles. You're gonna have to put up with me tripping over my words. It seems to be an annoyingly constant thing. I might add in little games and things along where I have to wear a costume selected by you for an episode, things like that. So hopefully we can make this fun and obviously as much as I enjoy the game, sometimes it can be a little bit frustrating. So we aim to make this as fun as possible. I will also grab the etherites on the way around so that you know where all those are. Travel around the city a little bit easier later on. Honestly, I think from here I tend to go the market or the Ark Castle, that's about it really. Obviously the Arcanist Guild while I'm doing the quests and things, but other than that I don't really go many places in Limsa, to be honest. I love this place. Obviously I'm recording this as I play, whereas before I kind of added the audio in later, which messed everything up, so that's why I'm doing it this way this time. I'll be pulling all the old ones down as I replace them. Hopefully these will be a little bit better. Oh, more importantly, hopefully I can actually finish this one. Instead of running all the way back, I'm going to do this. Jump to Hawkers. And then from there, I can go to the Fisherman's Guild. I won't be doing crafting and gathering. Maybe at some point, I don't know. But they're pretty bog standard, so I don't really see the point in doing those. But then you do need them for some of the Shadowbringers content, so maybe I'll level them at some point so that I can show you those particular quest chains and things. But that's a ways off yet, so I suppose I'm getting ahead of myself. Now, when I turn this quest in, it should lock out. So I should add that because it's extra XP, and extra XP is helpful. As predicted, it locked out. So I'll go get these two. So these are level 4s, are not going to be a major thing. I could literally do a quest and get the XP for it, but I'm not going to. I'm going to quickly just grab these. That should leave one. Which is this one here. Quickly grab that one. All right. It's So now we can teleport to the other two places if needed. But I'm just going to run up here. That's an event. It's a seasonal event, and obviously I can't do that right now. I'm not high enough. But I will grab it at some point and add it in as a special episode. Assuming, of course, I finish it on time. As you can see, I have a lot of bonuses. A lot of this is for playing the game, special codes, and events that have taken place over the years. Because I have collector's editions of all the games, and content that you pay for off the box station as well. The only one I've seen that I really, really like and really, really want at the minute is the magic carpet. Obviously, a lot of this is. And the old bonuses for being subscribed before they changed it. I think a lot of these, you can, the sub bonuses you can now get from. The guy in Gridania by the waterfall. So now that's done, I'll delete those. If you don't want to watch this, you can obviously skip ahead, or I might edit it out. Alright, it's done. I'll apply for the next slot. Run back to the half castle. We need to be level 4, so we are gonna jump 2. Middle. I know I'm doing terrible with that, I'm sorry. Let's take that lead. It feels really weird being out here without a chocobo. That's always helpful. I'm going to switch gear sets. I think one of them gives me a lot more XP, which for now is going to be super handy. I know I was just saying being out here without my chocobo is weird, but now I've got carbuncle, I should be okay. They changed the way pets worked. it used to make a difference, it doesn't now. Which is a shame, really. Extended myself, and I got physics, so we should be okay. And it's not as potent as a scholar's heal, but it'll do the trick. And it must be up pretty high. There we go. We should be able to run past without annoying anyone now. Or you want to go up there where those lights are. RLA or RLI, they're in the other one, so I'll grab them a little bit later. But for the moment, we're going to run up here. I'm going to grab that one. Which then enables me to do that. We use a ticket so that it doesn't cost us anything. Travel to the aft castle. And seeing as we're here, we'll go and get rid of those gifts. Yes, yes, we know. I think there's some for the invite a friend as well. So I have quite a few, to be honest. Obviously some of this is housing, some of it's minions. Mounts. All manner of weird and wonderful things. Fantasia allow you to change race? So yeah, there's lots of things. Bardins for chocobos. Level up even faster. As you can see, there's yet still more. I'm gonna grab this. Okay, so I have to go back to where I've just unlocked, but I'm gonna go finish the Arcanist quest first. Because once that's done, I can then probably unlock the next one. Oh, it should be up here. Those floating things over there, look. So we'll go grab those. Seriously, cabbie. Okay, see, that opens up that. But we're not going to do that just yet. Not close to high enough to unlock that yet. Okay, they're level 3, so theoretically. Sometimes there's a method to my madness, sometimes my madness is the method. This might get a bit dicey. Should be okay. Nope. Keep running. Hopefully I can outrun it. We're good. Time to come in here next time, we'll have it already unlocked and we can teleport straight there. Now we'll teleport to Summerford. We'll use the token, of course we will. Okay. Oh, there's something else I need to do. I need to do a couple of things to make the game easier. That we'll do momentarily. Take those because those are the ones that we need. Obviously, we're level 6, so. Obviously we need to be geared up, which we're not even close to at the minute, because we just have feet. So with that in mind, we'll head back to Windsor. I'm going to quickly show you a couple of quick quality of life things that I'm going to do. So I'm going to turn that off so that, because it annoys the hell out of me. And then I'm going to turn that on. Turn that to that. Because that makes my life easier. Okay. So I'm going to quickly head to the Ab Castle to get the remainder of these tokens. Why the hell am I on Exodus? God damn it. I don't need to delete this time. Head to the Arcanist Guild. So that we can turn this in, and that will be it for this episode. Quest, and then we are ready for next time. Okay.